Tech Pro here. Just got a hold of another slightly older PC. It looks quite good. Oops. Yeah, has some problems. Side panel's gone. That's for its time, a pretty good power supply. Asus graphics card. Gigabyte motherboard, Maxtor hard drive. As you see, a little bit not kept in the best of environments. I may or may not be able to get the side panel. Okay, now I understand how it opens. This side. Masters on some DVD writer, I would assume. And then there's some kind of a control center. This also opens. And then we see the actual horror. So anyway, I need to get this cleaned out.
Take this completely apart, and then if I get the side panel, I'll probably use it.
Get these two out. Should this one should connect to any car here? Oops. Don't think that control panel's actually being used.
Looks like this wire was used just to tie other things.
Oh, I don't really understand. Oh, they must have just been using it to tie up stuff. It's definitely not in use. If I don't get the side panel, then I don't know if I'll use it. Not the relative I got this one. Promise to look for. So, that's out. And that's an actually either CD valve. Ah, clean that. So this was a good machine for its day. That's why it's such a good idea to clean outside. Get away from the dust. So that's a little bit newer generation. It's even got a 6-pin power. And of course, a port hard drive. But this is a SATA hard drive. Not 200. Why is it written like that? No, that's the version. 200 gigabytes. That's right. Not terabytes, gigabytes. Just unscrew. So let's see. never put stuff on top of the PC. Oh, it's full stuff. But anyway, this is a main brand power supply, so it's, as I said, the capacity isn't that large, but it is a good quality one. And usually these main brand power supplies, you can actually load them a bit more than what the spec sheet says without them blowing up. And I have more. Should prevent the fan from turning if one's going to really blow a lot of the fan, so that it doesn't get into, doesn't go to hypersonic speeds, because then you ruin the bearings. So it seems to have had more than one save. It's getting more empty. See, it's got a full set of RAM. No idea how much at this point in time. Disconnect all this extra power stuff. Okay. Something here. It's these buttons. Okay, never seen that before.
See, it's this cable. It goes up there. I don't know what it... no idea what it connects to. Or is it a display? It's showing colors. Why would you put a wrong size fan? Side panel, then I don't know if I'm going to spend a lot of time cleaning up. It didn't come with any extra covers either, so it was all open. Yeah, so it was open for the backs. I don't know if this had some other cards. Weather's turning bad. Very big risk it's gonna start raining. Oh wait, we need to remember this has this lock. It has to be free. You see, it's one of these really yucky plastic ones. So it's for its day, quite a good. Don't know if the cooling is working that great on this one. But, yeah, it's relatively clean underneath. Yes.
So two DVI and one. We're never going to get this clean. I think we need to take that. Oh, that's really light. As I said, battery change. Even if it's not dead, it's worth changing. Huge screws for the model. Even work. Or is it just the... Oh, it was just the locating. And that's not a screw. That's not a screw. That's just like a locating pin. It's not dirty. So I'll just get this tool, this fan holder off. There's a lot of So let's see. Yep, and then filter. Let's make that out. Strength. There. So let's see. That's not that bad. Turns out this whole thing falls off. It's not actually any screws with it. So let's soak it down a bit. One could actually wash this with water now. There's no electronics in it. So I might actually take a hose to it. Cleaned up. Thank you. Sanitized enough. Probably some detailed cleaning is still needed. There's some places where there's stains. But, most common mistake in our region is coffee in the wrong place. Surprising to find coffee stains in places you don't expect to find. So, just have to go through the remaining miscellaneous parts, do the final cleaning. Now, the case worked out relatively good. Still a few little spots to handle, but that's good enough. So, bunch of stuff. 5 cage for the main filter, 2 fan holders. I think I'm gonna spray water on these. Now it's one time of its life, it's got hit on the back, so it's caved in there, but I've looked, there's no, don't see any physical damage or short circuit inside. Usually I don't recommend opening power supplies, and I'm not going to squirt cleaning liquid into this and take it on the paper and get it outside. The cables are quite clean though. They became relatively clean just by blowing on the air a little. And we did blow a lot of air through this process. Most of the dust should be gone. So I'm just going to give it an outside little clean. Something's sticky in there. Rougher surface.
thought, and then we'll just see if it works.
If it does. CD drive. Two side holders. Toolless. Drive hold. Look, I think this has been suffering a bit. Seems to clean up okay. Okay, now the only thing we need to do is to get this open, and that's probably there, so we need something very small to go in there. Finally found something that might go into a magic hole. Oh, that did not sound good. But we got it open. So now we can blow it out. And hope I didn't damage it. Okay, that's as good as it's gonna get. Oh. And if it works, it works, and if it doesn't, it doesn't. So this might have got some coffee on it. So. contact clean. About the extent that I like to try and clean it. It's got a lot of surface mount stuff, so one has to be very careful. There are actually brand new graphics cards where people have first time cleaned them with compressed air and they've blown components off the board and then it stops it from working. Oh, I think that's sort of good enough. Still dirty. Try to clean it up a bit. It's also that it can be that the plastic has aged. This is really dirt. I can't really see very much dirt. This was actually quite clean even in this position. I think we leave that like that. So quite a lot of dirt on this fan, but it's actually not looking that dirty. We did blow a lot of air onto this. So of course some people they remove the RAM and do lots of other extra cleaning and stuff, but I think that we've kind of blown it clean relatively carefully. I mean, it looks basically okay. So I think I'm just gonna leave it like it is. And then we'll see if it works. Yeah, we're not really filming the assembly because pretty much the reverse. The disassembly, but I put the CD-ROM on the top. Got rid of that temperature alarm control thing. And I took away this light control thing. I might put that back. And now I'm working in the insides. Getting all the cables reconnected. It's a lot easier to work now when it's clean. So the idea is to assemble it and then see what happens when we put it on. So now it's assembled and theoretically ready for testing. So anyway, now we have a little bit of a test set up here. So got the PC plugged into the monitor over there. And no idea if any of this is going to work. It was delivered. And basically, they said that it doesn't work, but exactly what doesn't work was not reported or known. So, anyway, let's put the power on first. Okay, so I'm just putting the main switch on. The power supply didn't blow anything up. See what happens when I when I put it on. So let's see if the disk drive came out. Okay. Wow! We have got a display. That is very strange. The CD tray came out. You can't see it in the film. Don't know why. Okay. Oh, starting Windows. Yeah. Oh my God. That is pretty amazing. That is not what I expected. Taking into account the bad condition the unit was in when I got it. I might need to censor the display if there's names and stuff that come up. Because I actually... This is Windows 7 Home Basic. Wow. With password protection enabled. Actually, don't have a mouse connected. So I think I need to borrow a mouse and see. I actually don't intend to use this hard drive with the OS on it. I was actually thinking of installing some other operating system before I use it, because Windows 7 Home Basic is not. Yeah. So, mouse. So, it's network cable connected, mouse connected, keyboard connected, but I don't see a mouse person. The mouse is getting powered. Or is it just the waiting game? Should see a mouse. Maybe it still hasn't been booted for years. Probably. Most likely. But the graphics card fan is turning, the CPU fan's okay. Power supply is okay. Hard drive makes a lot of noise. It's really doing something. Keyboard doesn't work. I mean, it's so active now. We'll see if it actually... I mean, Windows 7 Home Basic should support USB keyboard mouse combination. Hard to think that would be the issue. And the ports seem to be working because the power it's getting out. Somehow I don't think the keyboard's been recognized yet. So it's plugged in a different set of ports. Strange. Well, it was in good working order. Magic. One just had to wait patiently. This is still running. It's the hard drive is still doing a lot. But now I have a mouse cursor and the keyboard works. So I think it was just doing something in the background. Windows 7, whatever it was doing. But I can't actually get into this account because it's got a password. And anyway, I'm going to actually clean this format. Okay, so that terminates this demonstration. Network seems to be up and running. Keyboard, mouse, all the electronics seems to be running. Can't see any problems. So, yeah, I think we successfully saved this from the trash pile, and it will serve a new good purpose in my own use. So, hope you liked all this. It was quite exciting. Still a bit amazed that it actually was working. As I said, I have to think about what OS I'm going to throw on. But something a bit more exciting than just Windows 7 Home, basically, before I actually put it into use. So, anyway, see you in the next one.
Yeah, just the final word about the keyboard not activating directly. This actually has some so-called PS2 connectors for both keyboard and mouse. And it turns out that the BIOS on this unit does not support USB keyboard or mouse. So you can't operate anything related to the BIOS. So it has to actually wait for the actual USB keyboard to activate. Then it needs to wait for Windows to boot so it can load the drivers. Interesting. Back in the day, you could get an adapter from PS2 to USB. And sadly, I actually don't have any of them remaining anymore. So, actually, I've ordered them. Because the only way to operate the keyboard in the BIOS is to actually go through those ports. And I don't have a PS2 keyboard or mouse.